Hello everyone. Today, I am going to talk to you about atom bombs. Confused? Okay, I'm going to talk to you about guests. Still not getting it? Okay, chums, I'm going to talk to you about periods, a topic that's been so hushed that it has zillion code words to hide the secret. I just learned that it has 5,000 code words in just 10 languages. It's a secret which we keep hiding, not just from men, but also from women. That's the reason why men don't know why their mother, wife, or a friend is irritable, exhausted, or maybe planning to kill him on those certain days. And those certain days are the premenstrual syndrome, that is the PMS, and the mood swings which happen before and during periods. But men probably don't know that because we keep hiding the secret. This secret has been hidden and we use different words for that. But it starts from very small things. I remember how my mother used to ask me to hide my drying underwear from my brother. It happens from a very young age. And it's done because we feel that men will feel the disgust. It will be shameful. But I believe if men ask it out of curiosity, the conversation will begin. The disgust will go off. But that doesn't happen. If this happens, it will be a chance to normalize periods and men will know more about it. So how are we managing menstruation? A lot of people are working on menstruation. Different government agencies, individuals are working on menstruation. They're talking about taboos, they're talking about practices. At the same time, various government agencies are working on different schemes, programs, distribution of products, movies and advertisements are also talking about menstruation. This is a very good sign indeed, but we are dealing with just one side of the problem. The problem of hiding the menstrual flow. Are you getting it, my point? This is just one side of the problem. And how are we doing it? Let's look at the first picture. I don't think we bleed blue. All the women here will agree with me, I guess. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So, I will just share a small experience with my friend. My friend got periods very late than us. For 3 whole years, she believed that she will bleed blue. And she was highly disappointed to see red blood on her first period. The next incident, we always see the advertisements where it shows a pad soaks 1 beaker full of liquid and the clot doesn't. But my question is, we bleed for 3 to 4 days. Does a pad need to soak the whole liquid in just 1 day in 1 pad? I don't think it should. So let me give you a reality check. I used to believe that we bleed like Brahmaputras between our legs. I think all women will agree on this also. But what I'm going to tell you is going to shock you. Because on an average, we women bleed just 35 ml of blood, that is 2.5 tablespoons. And depending on person to person, it will be 10 to 80 ml, that is 1 to 6 tablespoons, just that. And we feel like a river is flowing between our legs. But that's just an illusion because we have been told that we will bleed so much because we see the beaker ad. And the next advertisement, where a girl is been playing. I don't think most of us want to do that even on normal days. I won't do that personally. But we are believed to do that. And the next thing is, we are dealing with this problem for many years. Why don't we just Why can't we just rest or slow down if we want to do that? Such advertisements influenced me to move from cloth, which my mom had taught me to use, to disposable pads. They promised me freedom, hygiene, cleanliness, and convenience. Then I started dreaming of beautiful, painless periods. But I was highly disappointed because that didn't happen to me, and I blamed myself for being that. 23% of girls drop out of the school during adolescence. And this reason is been cited by many advertising companies, sanitary companies, to promote their products. But a survey done by Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan in 2008 has studied that, one, that girls drop out from school, but the percentage of boys who drop out from the school is 1.6% greater than girls. So, is that the reason why girls drop out of the school? The one of the reasons will be early marriage and early pregnancy. That makes me wonder and question the products available. Then I moved to Karli Kota cabin in Dantewada. I faced several issues there. When I went there, my first issue was, where will I get my pads? So it took me a month to figure out that, okay, I have to travel for an hour to just get a set of pads. I did that. Then, once I started using them, I had no clue how to dispose my pads. In cities, it's so convenient. We just toss our pads in dustbin, or we just give them to waste pickers. But this doesn't happen in villages. And it's not just this. I tried burning them, but wet pads didn't burn. Then I tried burying them, but dogs exhumed them and they were all everywhere. I don't think we will like that sight. Later I tried throwing them away, like any other woman will do in a village. I saw a few pads thrown away in the villages. I did the same. I thought this may solve the problem, I don't know. But it didn't happen. It wasn't the correct way either. I started feeling guilty and responsible for my waste. I couldn't find a way. So I started reading about it. I came to know many things. I also understood that there are many things which we don't think about. So while thinking about it, I was thinking of throwing pads away. But can anyone of you tell me where is a way? Away means where? Can anyone show me that place? No one. We don't know the answer to this question. But when I read about it, I came to know, when we throw the pads in dustbin, they go to the landfill where sanitation workers segregate the waste by their bare hands. If we try to burn these pads emit toxic fumes and dioxins in the air. Dioxins are related to endocrine disruptors. If we throw these pads in the toilets, they clog the drains, and manual scavengers have to get down to remove this clog, to remove this pad, so that the drains are unclogged. They do this all with their bare hands without any safety. So in a way, we are risking lives of two parts of our community. That is the manual scavengers who risk their life and are exposed to skin and respiratory disorders, and we are exposing the sanitation workers to skin infections. I feel, why are we doing it? This simply didn't answer my problem. So if we see, we are posing risk, we are pressing our needs, and we are also, we are not only disturbing the environmental balance, but we are also pressing the waste management. We are also putting trouble on our health, and not just our health, but also the health of sanitation workers. So if we see some more things in environment, we will come to know, have anyone of us has wondered how many pads must be thrown away in a month? So there was an interesting survey done by Down to Earth in 2013, which stated that if 12% of 300 million women menstruating women use sanitary pads, they would throw 432 million soiled pads a month. That is 9,000 tons a month, which is very much enough to cover a landfill spread over 24 hectares. Isn't that shocking? It really broke my heart when I read that. Later, I also came to know that one pad is equal to 4 plastic bags. So we need to really think about it. And we look at the health aspects, which is really ignored by us, is if this pad has been used for more than 12 hours, these pads give us comfort that we can use it for more than 8 hours, 10 hours. But no one tells us that these pads need to be changed after 4 to 6 hours. And if they're used for long hours, or if they are reused by washing it, which village women do it, and I have seen it by my eyes, this leads to many infections called vulvar dermatitis, then many other small skin infections, but we don't know it. I just see a lot of women in cities who buy sofromycin, a tube used as an anti-insecticide. So that's that, and pads together, which means that they get rashes every time they use pads. And the health of sanitary workers and manual scavengers is simply ignored. We don't even think about them. Okay, please don't give up hope. Calm down. There are better solutions to this. So there are better solutions which give us all the different things and also sustainable at the same time. So there are products like menstrual cups, cloth pads, which we could reuse, and they can be reused for many years, hence they will be sustainable and they are comfortable and dignifying all at the same time. But you may be still wondering, will that solve my problem? Yes, to some extent it really did answer my problem, and it took me some time to figure out the whole question and the whole answer for myself. I started using reusable menstrual products 3 years ago when I was living in Dantewada. I tried stitching my own pads and I did a decent job. My students also loved them, and so while making a different conversations with my students, I also taught them to make cloth pads, and they really liked it. And this is how I became guilt-free and I started learning more about myself. So this is a beautiful picture of cloth pads. I believe they are really cute, and I believe that may change your perception about the word cute and beautiful. So these cloth pads are very convenient, they are very comfortable, and they could be reused up to 3 to 5 years depending on what type of fiber it's used. But mostly they are natural fibers used, made from cotton. Most of us know that cotton is very breathable and very gentle on our skin. So these cloth pads, they are a very convenient option these days, and you can just use it while you're traveling, and once you reach home, you can just put them in water and wash them very easily. Then there are menstrual cups. I think lots of people may be knowing about it because recently there are many Facebook groups who are talking about menstrual cups and cloth pads. In one Facebook group which I know, that is Sustainable Menstruation India, there are already 15,000 members who are using such products. That group is all across India. So these menstrual cups are internally woven product, and they could be reused up to 10 years. You just need to wash it with a glass full of water, that's it. Since they are internally woven product, you can do swimming, running, cycling, and so many things because they are enjoyable. I will not say that it will make your life painless. I won't claim that. But that will make few things enjoyable which you can't do by wearing a pad. But you may be still wondering why I'm talking about this, making the switch, and how will it really help me? So if we look at some aspects, so money is the first aspect which I would look into. So the annual expenditure on disposable pads, have you ever done that math? So let's do it today. If a woman uses 12 pads in a month, she will spend across 840 rupees, approximately 840 rupees, depending on the brand you use. She will spend 840 rupees per year. If the same woman uses cloth pads, she will spend 1600 rupees for once, and she will use those pads for 3 to 5 years, depending on the weather and the hardness of water. But if she uses menstrual cup, she can reuse the same cup for 10 years, which she buys for 800 or 2000 rupees, depending on which one is suitable for her. So you save a lot of money. Environment. I think a lot of people think that now there is new community coming up called environment Nazis, like there are grammar Nazis. So these environment Nazis are eco nuts. So why we are pressing this problem? We want to solve this problem because environment is something. If we are just taking from it, we are not giving it anything. So if you start using reusables, I think you should definitely give environment something. You will stop the waste which goes to landfill. You will also stop different types of waste. You will start segregating your waste by yourself. You will save different lives by not giving pads to waste pickers and also not risk the lives of manual scavengers, because you will reuse the products for many years. There are health aspects too. So there will be reduced infections. Then, since there are no dioxins involved, because as I mentioned before, there are dioxins involved because the pads which we use, they are made from cellulose, and to make them look white, the dioxins have been bleaching has been done, and that bleaching leads to dioxins in the air. So there are no endocrine disruptors involved in cloth pads or menstrual cups. It's a breathable fabric. Even cups are very breathable. They are made from hypoallergenic medical grade silicone, which doesn't affect our body. And there are no allergies. And these products are really comfortable. There is no irritation, rarely any irritation, no rashes. They are easy to wash, easy to use, easy to carry, gentle on skin. And they come in different sizes. Yes, you heard it right. They are not like the different sanitary pads, which come in standardized sizes. They come in different sizes. And they could be customized, like some vendors in cloth pads, they do customize you according to the needs. Then they are very convenient. They are leak-proof. So cloth pads have a leak-proof layer, and cups form a seal, hence they are leak-proof. I remember when I was a kid, like kid I will say, because I got periods when I was just 9 years old. So I used to ask everyone, is my skirt red, is my skirt red? Because I wasn't sure that whether my cloth or the pad I use will be leak-proof. So, and we all believe again that we bleed like Brahmaputras. So yeah, we believe that. So no more checking on your backside whether you have having leaks. They're easy to use. And yes, the monthly trips to the medical stores have been saved. Yes, I really don't like going to every month to the medical store and asking him, "Bhaiya, stay free, doge," and he will look at you with those gaze, and he will wrap it in so many layers, and again the plastic bag, and when you're at home, you will take at least 10 minutes to just unwrap it. Then I wonder, when will I use my pad if I have spent 10 minutes in just unwrapping it? Also, these products could be used for white discharge. Lot of women's face issues of white discharge. And the most important thing which affected me very much is that you save a lot of tossed pads. There are many women out there who have the fear that I may get period this day. Okay, I don't want to ruin my TED talk. I'm going to wear white and I don't want to ruin my dress. So I will just wear a pad. But there are very less chances that I may get period on this day, on a particular day. So we toss so many pads in the dustbin. But if you use a reusable menstrual cup or a cloth pad, you can just wash it and reuse it. You don't have to throw anything. So I started with myself. And I believe if we start this conversation by ourselves, we can do it with everyone. And the taboos will be reduced and the periods will be looked as a normal phenomenon. Thank you for listening.